Subscribe and press the bell icon on YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello everyone, I'm Anston from Media Technology, MIT Manipal. Today we have with us a very special guest, one of the heroes of the printing and visual media industries, Mr. Ramu Ramanathan. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
You successfully managed to be an author, editor, playwriter, poet, a teacher. What's the secret behind attaining such perfection in multitasking?
I think my worry is that there are only 24 hours in a day. I wish there were more. That would have helped me in life. But I think everyone I'm surrounded by generally does so much more. So the possibilities of doing that is constantly pushing me. And one, you know, each of these things feed onto each other. So playwriting feeds into printing, printing feeds into teaching, and so on and so forth. So always something to learn. And, you know, one of my heroes is Alois Senefelder, as I mentioned. And as you know, he was a playwright, he was a theatre person, and of course an inventor and an innovator. So I feel I've probably achieved 0.1% of what Mr. Senefelder has, so there's still a long way to go.
Criticism helps one grow. Mm. During your career, have you received any criticism? How has this helped you?
So I had penned a play called The Boy Who Stopped Smiling, which was then produced by Little Prithvi Players, and that was Sanjana Kapoor and so on. And that play had a fairly successful run, 150, 200 shows. And since I had directed and written the play, what had happened was, like all first-time directors, I used to travel with the show. And for those of you who are familiar with, you know, theatre productions, it's a fairly hectic and tiring kind of an activity. So one of the latter shows, I think the 89th or 100th show of the play, one of our great theatre legends, Vijay Tendulkar Saab, he had come for the show, he'd seen the show, and then the next day he'd called me home. And he specifically told me that, look, your job is to write plays. Your job is not to be a tali master, in the sense that you're not supposed to be there on each show, maintaining discipline, ensuring the show must happen. What we expect from you is to be writing at least 4 to 5 great plays every year. Continue and stick to your job and don't do things which you're not meant to do. So, and I think that was good advice, because I slowed down on that front and continue to write more plays.
Why do you prefer using unique titles in your work, like Cotton 56, Polyester 84, Comrade Kumbhakarna?
So I think, again, all great playwrights, you know, be it Shakespeare, be it Bhas, be it, you know, even Tendulkar Saab, Karnad, whoever, all of them have obviously, you know, the title is the sort of preview to an audience to come and see the play. So the title has to be absolutely A, precise, and B, something that entices an audience to invite them to come and see the show. So, great thought goes into that.
Yes. So you write about social, cultural and political realities of today. What made you choose this genre?
So I had written a play called Mahadev Bhai, which is about, you know, based on the diaries of Mahadev Desai, who was Gandhiji's secretary from 1919 to 1942. So that process was very exciting and interesting for me, where A, you get to sort of look at, you know, important chapters of Indian history, and then be able to translate and adapt those chapters for the stage. Okay. So essentially forgotten heroes, people who are in the shadows, you know, giving a voice to the voiceless. I think those are things that excite me. And especially, you know, looking at the enormous struggle that a whole lot of people have put into. So that's what gets translated on stage.
Okay. So what motivates you to write?
Usually it's a deadline. And so you know, most of the times I'm writing for groups which have performance dates in advance, so we are normally working backwards from those dates. So I have an opening date in mind, and then broadly I know I have to write, because the actors are waiting in the you know, wings, and they need the script. So that's generally the thumb rule for me.
So personally, what does literary success look like to you?
Literary success for me is basically, so I have I'm fortunately married to someone who is probably the toughest person to please on the planet. So if I get a pat from her at the end of a day, it's fairly rewarding. It's, I think, sort of, you know, in comparative terms, it would probably be equivalent to maybe 10 million likes on Facebook and one pack. So it's that important for me. Yeah. Hmm.
So are you working on any new projects?
Oh, yes, quite a few. So there's one which is on, again, an extraordinary woman who fought for Adivasi rights in close to a place in Mumbai, since you mentioned you're from Mumbai. So this is a area called Varli. So she is Godavari by Parulekar, who fought for the landless at that time during the colonial regime. And again, important lessons, because what she fought for, those, you know, struggles remain equally important. Then there was an artist called Ara, who was again an unknown person who was spotted, and his, you know, he used to wash cars. And then he became an important part of the progressive art movement. So again, something about him, and so actually there are about, you know, typically what happens with any writer is you have about 2 to 3 dozen ideas, and then depending on the priority deadline, then you dovetail into one of those. So there are quite a few.
Okay, so we thank you very much,
right,
and wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.